Some experts believe China is on the rise to replace the United States as the top global power, but Teddy Locsin Jr. believes otherwise. Here's tonight's Teditorial.
I like Martin Jacques's book because its author has two first names and because it promised to be a corrective. Jacques's book answers those that claim the opposite. China is on the verge of meltdown and breakup. But Einstein said that anything that travels closer to the speed of light gets fatter. China has been developing at light speed, but morally regressing at the same rate. It gave up China's sole concession to civilization, the iron rice bowl that guaranteed no Chinese would go hungry. China mastered the art of standing on the shoulders of giants. Its progress is grounded on the mass and cheap imitation of American products from American discoveries. This was only right. If America had its way, its inimitable products would be priced way out of range of even American consumers. This is because America has adopted conflicting philosophies, the free market on the one hand, and there is no such thing as a free lunch or a cheap one for that matter. But one after another, China took American products and processes and cheapened them to within the reach of every man. The Asian tigers, China foremost, have been giving the world the Black Friday Thanksgiving sale ever since, without having to line up the night before and scramble the morning after. Okay, forget quality. Chinese products do not last. But who wants this year's fashion in clothes and gadgets next year? So Martin Jacques is right. China's economy, which supplies the world, will be twice bigger than America's. But its power surpasses America's, not in 500 years, if ever. American technology will continue to outstrip the rest of the world by 500 years. Its innovation and its capability to turn its ideas into its products, especially military technology and its civilian uses, will remain unmatched for the next 500 years. The Chinese economy will grow, but that will have no effect on the global balance of power, tilted at close to a 90-degree angle toward the United States. It will stay that way, so long as America offers what China never did or ever could: superior civilization in the true meaning of the word civilized. America invented the constitutional ban on cruel and unusual punishments. China invented death by a thousand cuts. Keep well.